So if you're headed south, be sure to give yourself some extra time.
And the incoming strong winds have farmers now bracing for more damage after a weekend full of rain, hail, and winds.
23 ABC's Jessica Harrington is live in Northwest Bakersfield with more on how the weather is impacting crops. Jessica.
Yeah, Jackie and Tim, take a look at this. There are almonds all over the ground. And as you can see, there's trees knocked over. They're all over the place here, too. And this is just the aftermath of yesterday's winds. And with more heavy winds on their way, there could be more to come.
Once the tree comes down, the tree is done.
Tammy Harris lives in Shafter, surrounded by 20 acres of almond trees. Luckily, her trees are young and mostly held up against the strong winds.
Due to the size of the tree and the age, it has not knocked them over. With high winds and older trees, it tends to rip them out of the ground.
And while she lost a few almonds to the ground, compared to other properties, it could have been worse.
If the tree is ripped out of the ground, basically the root system is gone.
She says the roots are only 3 to 4 inches deep, so with older trees, wind can easily knock them down. And the age difference shows just across the street from Harris's property as trees lay uprooted.
Obviously, the more trees you lose, the less money, because at this point, you know, we've already put so much money into the trees.
And at Murray Family Farms, the cherry trees have also been battling the wind and rain.
It was kind of an unusual El Nino because we thought it was going to rain and then it didn't, and then it did. And when the rain came, it was a little late and light to do good on the water in the mountains, but it was a little bit hard on the cherries.
Murray says the rain can cause the cherries' skin to split, the hail can knock them off the tree, and the wind can cause the cherries to rub together and bronze, all things that make them unable to be sold.
2 weeks ago that we were sitting on one of the best crops we've seen in years, and now we're looking at, you know, paying for our picking costs and having enough money to pay back the bank our operating line of credit.
And while Murray Family Farm says that they lost most of the crop that they've called the best crop they've had in years, they say that the cherry season's going to be fine because there are many other varieties that did just fine in the weather. And farmers weren't the only ones that saw damage from the weather. Local residents also saw damage. We're going to send it over to 23 ABC's Alicia Patillo with more on that.